Well, yes, students, good morning to you all. Today our topic is cash book. In the previous class, I already explained about cash book. Now I am going through solving a problem. Here, there is a problem which is carried from CA foundation course. CA foundation course. Page number 2.72. Example illustration number 3. Well, dear students, now I am doing this problem. Here, enter the following transactions in cash book with discount and bank columns. That means it is a triple column cash book. Triple column cash book. It is a cash book as well as a cash account, so it must be in T shape. Left side is debit, right side is credit. Debt, particulars, LF, cash, discount allowed, and bank. Debt, particulars, LF, cash, here discount received, and bank. These are all receipts. These are all payments. Receipts means they are coming in, whether they are cash or checks. These are payments, that means going out, whether cash payment or check payments. Look here. This is the problem. Enter the following transactions in triple column cash book. Checks first treated as cash receipts. What it means, whenever we receive a check, first it is taken as cash and then we can deposit in the bank. Whenever we receive a check, it is taken as cash receipt. Understanding? Look here, first one, January 1st, 2016. Chandrika started business. Immediately, on 3rd, he paid into current account. Paid into current account is nothing but bank account. In the bank, you can maintain either savings account or current account. You can maintain savings account or current account. Generally, the business people maintain current account only. Now, he paid into bank. Here, Chandrika is there. Now it is given he. Chandrika, whether he or she, I don't know. No problem. Whether he or she, in accountancy, no question of third person he or she, no question of second person you, we have to feel always we are Chandrika. We started the business. We received money. We paid into bank. Understanding? We have to feel that we are doing the problem in our books. In our books. So we are Chandrika. We started business with a capital of 20,000. January 1st. When we started business, cash is coming. Cash account at all to capital account. Cash account at all to capital account. This is the cash account. Debt or to capital account. $20,000. Well, dear students, following our matter, we started the business. We have to feel that we are doing the problem in our books. Don't feel that Chandrika, he, she, we don't think about them. we started the business, that means we have to fill as Chandrika. Cash is coming, cash account debtor, two capital account. Cash account debtor, two capital account. Next, paid into current account, paid into bank. Bank account debtor, two cash account. It is a contra entry. Bank account debtor, two cash account. Bank account debtor, bank account debtor, debtor side, you have to write down two cash. 19,000. Immediately cash account is created. Cash account is created. On credit side, you have to write down by bank. Once again, we deposited money in the bank, we paid money into bank, we sent money to bank, all are same. Bank account debtor to cash account. Bank account is debited to cash. Cash account is created by bank. Understand? This is only contra entry. You can put in LF column as C. C means contra. C for contra, B for Bombay, P for Pune, like that C for contra. Look here. Now fourth, received a check from Kirti. Received a check from Kirti. We already told, whenever we received a check, temporarily it is assumed as cash. So cash is coming. Cash account debtor to Kirti. Cash account debtor to Kirti. ₹600. Well, dear students, we received cash. Cash is coming. Cash account debtor to Kirti. Though it is a check, temporarily we are assuming as cash. We are taking as cash. Always no need to read or remembering the journal entry. Just coming, you can write down receipts. Going, you can write down on credit side, that is payment side. Following, no need to go through journal entry. Directly coming, cash coming or check coming debit side. Cash going or check going on credit side. Now come to 7th. Keep this check paid into bank, deposited into bank. This 600 check we deposited in the bank. Previously just on 4th we assumed as cash. Now the same check, the same cash we deposited in the bank. Understanding? 2 days back, just when we received check, we have taken as cash. The same check we are depositing today in the bank. So, the same check means the same cash we are depositing. Bank account debtor to cash. Again, contra. Bank account debtor. Debtor side, we have to write down to cash. In the bank. Again, credit side. By bank, ₹600. This is also contra. So C for contra. Following or not, please look here once again. We received check previously on 4th, that is taken as cash. The same cash now we deposited in the bank. Bank account debtor to cash. A check received previously, now deposited in the bank, is a contra entry. Bank account debtor to cash. Next, pays Ratan by check and is allowed discount. He allowed discount. Ratan allowed discount to us. That means we received a discount. Try to understand. There is a discount allowed, is there? It is discount allowed, not like that. He allowed discount to us. Understanding? When we are paying, we are receiving discount. We are receiving discount. Paid Ratan, by Ratan. By check. Check means you can take it in bank column. Discount received ₹20. Okay. Now, Tripathi pays into bank account. Tripathi is our old customer. He paid directly money into our account. Who is receiving our cash? Bank is receiving. So bank account debit off to Tripathi. Bank received how much? 475. Look here. Received a check from Varshi. Discount allowed 35 and amount is 450. We received a check from Varshi. Day 15. All receipts are debit side. To Varshi. Day 27. Pays first punch allowance on 35.
Made purchases.
Day 27. We received 450 by check. But temporarily we are taking as cash.
So nothing is mentioned. Cash so trading cash. 275.
Check we are receiving temporarily.
Next one loss.
Cash.
Date so cash.
Paid sundry expenses. Paid sundry
expenses.
Now. Receives cash. 75. And check 100 rupees towards per se.
Paid in cash.
Cash is already cash.
Well,
and check also we are assuming as cash.
By purchases.
So cash
by sundry expenses.
20.
That's over.
Who says?
Over.
Now, the last step in direct we can take cash from
here.
We have to
both
make
back.
Here cash we receive to.
And check we receive.
Both are taken as cash.
The other side must be the double. Last day 25. Pays into bank now, including
you can
take check
any side
and
side is
check.
More.
Here, debt side is more.
This
generally cash column always
50
from
not generally.
It is a check.
100% cash
and 100 rupees
received towards
debit
sales.
Must be more.
That is also a check.
So debit side
50
plus 100, 550 rupees.
Not only that, 550 rupees, and we added
450. 21 to 25
on the bank.
Here also 21 to 25
on the bank. 1,000 rupees, sir. Bank
now we have to find the difference. To cash. We divided, so 300 rupees balance. That is called Vyan 31st by balance carried down.
By bank.
By balance carried down.
Understanding?
We told on the different sides.
The same total is taken on the right side.
All the paid items we have to deduct from this total, find out the balance.
Understanding
the balance is called balance.
Previously,
we received a check.
This
machine,
for
no need to balance.
And we received a check for sales.
Also, yes, we have
100 rupees.
No need to
both the checks comes to total of
500.
Bank also generally
shows
different balance, but sometimes it may show great balance, which is called
over
that. Just can't cash.
Over that. But here, only credit side one item is there. Debit only more. Total debit side. $21,075. $20,745. This is the closing bank balance. 300 is the cash balance. 20,745 is the bank balance. They are on 31st January. Now, the same balances we have to carry forward to next month. That is 5th. Two balance brought down. We have to take only cash amount. Our cash balance and bank balance. Discount column, just we total at the end of every month, that totals are transferred to their respective accounts. Discount allowed is transferred to discount allowed account, and the discount received total is transferred to discount received account. The discount column should not be balanced, that totals are directly transferred to the respective accounts. In the ledger, now we have balance, cash balance of 300 rupees and bank balance of 20,745 rupees as on February 1st. Understanding or not? This is the problem solving, triple column cash book, triple column cash book, cash column, discount column and bank column. Three columns are there. It is a cash book as well as a cash account. But it is a T-shape only, account shape only, debit side and credit side. Just you have to enter all these transactions here. Whenever you are entering, you can go through generalizing system or just you can think whether coming or going. When cash or checks coming debit side, when cash or checks going on credit side. Well, dear students, please take down. I will do one more problem. Okay. Well, dear students, here one more problem is there. Now I am going through this problem. Then after I will explain once again all the important points to be remembered. Now, triple column cash book. Well, dear students, this is also a problem from CA Foundation course, page number 2.80, illustration number 5. Illustration number 5. Triple column cash book. Debit, credit, debt, particulars, LF, cash, discount allowed, and bank. Date, particulars, LF, cash, discount received, and bank. Well, dear students, here all receipts. Here are payments. Well, dear students, here this arrow indicating that the amounts are coming in. Here the arrow indicating that they are going out. Money comes on debit side, going on credit side. Now come to the problem. On March 1st, we have cash in hand 15,000. On the same day, we have overdraft balance with bank 500 rupees. So, March 1st, two balance brought down in cash 15,000. In bank, there is a overdraft. It is a credit balance. By balance brought down. Well, dear students, overdraft means the amount overdrawn from bank. Understand? We overdraw the amount from the bank than our deposit amount, our balance amount. Suppose I have 10,000 in the bank, but I withdrawn 10,500, then 500 is called overdraft. By taking permission from the bank manager, we can take overdraft. So overdraft is always credit balance. It is a liability. It is a liability. It always credit balance. So credit side by balance brought down 500 rupees. Now second, date second, cash sales, two sales. Sales means money coming. So debit side, Next, paid to Sushil by check. We paid. It is a payment by Sushil. Paid by bank. Paid by check means bank. 3,400. Next, sales through credit card. Whether it is a debit card or credit card, the amounts are received by our bank only. So, two sales. By credit card, that means bank collected this amount, 2,800. Okay, now received a check from Srizan. Who received a check? Date 6th. To Srizan. Well, dear students, when we received a check, temporarily it can be taken as cash. Then after 2 or 3 days, you can deposit in the bank. But right now, on the next date, it is not deposited. That means we can assume that it is deposited on the same day. Understand or not? Once again, suppose received check today, date 6th. After 8th or 9th, if it is deposited in the bank, temporarily you can take it in cash and then you can deposit. It is a contra entry. But right now it is not mentioned when it is deposited. Then we can assume that it is deposited on the same day. Bank account debit or to Srizan. Bank account debit or to Srizan. So, it must be taken in the bank. How much? 6,200. Next. Date 7th. The above check is endorsed to Adit. We endorse. You know endorsement? Check, bills of exchange, promissory note, they are all called negotiable instruments which are freely transferable from one to another. They are freely transferable. We received a check from Srizan. Now we are giving to Adi. He will collect the amount from bank. So we are transferring or endorsing in favor of Aditya. Who is the receiver? Aditya. Aditya account debit to bank. So, by Aditya, 6,200. Understand or not? Endorsement is nothing but transfer of bill or check or promissory note by one person to another person. That is called endorsement. One who transfers is an endorser. To whom it is transferred is called an endorsee. Now we are the endorser. Aditya and boss. Okay. Date 9. Deposited money in the bank. Deposited in the bank. Bank account debit to cash. It is a contra entry. Bank account debit to cash. 6,800. By bank. In cash column, it is a contra. So we are taking, we are putting as C. C for contra. Next, 10th, received a check from Avigal and deposited on the same day. We received the check and deposited on the same day. So bank is the receiver, bank account debtor. Avigal is the giver. Two Avigal account. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. You have to follow the principles always. So, then only it becomes easy. Who is the receiver? Bank. Bank account debit to Avigal. How much? 3,600. In the discount column, 50 rupees. Next, Adit informed that Srizan's check is dishonored. We already received a check from Srizan and it is endorsed to Adit. Adit now informed to us, sir, you have given a check that is not collected. It is dishonored. It is bounce. Check bounce. That means, again our debtor becomes a debtor and creditor becomes a creditor. From whom actually you have to receive? Srizan. Srizan again becomes debtor. Srizan account debtor. We have to pay to whom?
Aditya. To Aditya. This is the entry file. Endorsed check dishonored.
Understand or not? We already endorsed to whom? Aditya. That is dishonored. So, Srizan account debtor to Aditya. It may not affect here. May not affect here. Now, we immediately received cash from Srizan. Cash account debtor to Srizan. Cash account debtor to Srizan. How much Srizan check? 6,200. And we paid to Adit by our own check. We issued our own check to Adit. Aditya account debtor to bank. So by Aditya. 6,200. Okay. Well, dear students, here 6,200 is there. This is here also 6,200 is there. The check is cancelled already. Now we received cash from Srizan and we paid to Aditya. It is a separate receipt, it is a separate payment. Understanding? Now, come to 15th, sales by debit card. Date 15th, two sales by debit card, 3,200. I told you, whether it is credit card or debit card, bank only collecting money. So, bank account debtor, two sales. Withdrawn from bank, 1,800. Cash account debtor to bank. It is also contra entry. Cash account debtor to bank. Day 24th. To bank. In the cash column, 1,800. By cash. In the bank column, 1,800. It is also contra. Paid to Sanchit. 3,000 rupees Sanchit. By check. So it is in bank column. Well, dear students, last point. Date 30th. Bank charged 1% commission on credit card or debit card sales. Sales already here by credit card 2,800 is there, and sales by debit card 3,200 is there. 2,800 plus 3,200, that is equal to 5,000. Well, 5,000. Hare, 2,800, 3,200, the total is equal to 6,000. On 6,000, 1% commission, that becomes 60 rupees. Who is charging? Banker is charging. We have to pay. Bank charges is also an expenditure. It must be debited. Bank charges account debtor to bank. Bank charges account debtor to bank. So, by bank charges, it is also a payment. We have to pay to bank 60 rupees. That's over. Well, dear students, all the transactions will post it in the triple column, cash book. Now, what is the last step? We have to make it balance. Total of debit side first step, 6,200, this is 8,000. 8 plus 18, that is equal to 26,000. Discount column, 50 rupees. Bank, though in the beginning we have overdraft, right now we have more balance here. So total of debit side. But whenever credit side is more, you have to total credit side first. Understanding? Whether debit or credit, which side is more, that side you have to total. That only is system of balancing. So here, $26,000 cash total. Here discount not there. Bank column 22,600.
Now we have to take down the balances, the differences.
This is March 31st, by balance carried down.
Now here,
$1,440. That is the bank balance. Where dear students, these are the balances at the end of the month, March 31st. How much cash we have? $19,200. How much bank balance we have? $1,440. They will be brought down to the next month, April 1st. Two balance brought down in cash column, $19,200, and bank column, $1,440.
Well, dear students, I told you already, discount amount column should not be balanced. The totals are directly transferred to discount allowed account or discount received account to the ledger.
Well, dear students, any doubt you can ask? First, please take down. Then we will discuss about the doubts. Are all important points to be remembered. Okay? Please.
Well, dear students, we solved already two problems, and I want to explain just about the checks received. Whenever we received a check, here we received a check from Srizar. We written as bank account debtor to Srizar. Whenever we received a check, if it is deposited on the same day, this entry is okay. Bank account debtor to Srizar. Whenever we received a check and it is assumed that it is deposited on the same day, then also it is okay. This is correct. But whenever check received is given, this is on 6th, suppose on 8th or 9th, if it is given, it is deposited in the bank. That means we received on one day, but it is deposited on the another day. Then you must write down two entries. When we received check, temporarily you can take it as cash account debtor to Srizar. And if it is deposited, bank account debtor to cash. When we have to write down these two entries, check received on one day, but it is deposited on the another day, then you have to write down this type of two entries. Here cash we received and it is deposited in the bank, cash debit, cash credit cancelled, there is only bank account debtor to Srizar. Here also bank account debtor to Srizar. Understand or not? So this entry you can write down whenever it is deposited on the same day, or whenever it is assumed that it is deposited on the same day. But in the problem, received date is separately given, deposited date separately given, then you must write down like this only. Or one more way is there, we received the check on one day, on that day you can write down checks in hand debtor to Srizar. And when it is deposited in the bank, bank account debtor to checks in hand. Here also checks in hand once debited, checks in hand once credited, So it is automatically cancelled.
Still there is bank account debit to Sri Sahni. Bank account debit to Sri Sahni. Bank account debit to Sri Sahni. All are same effect. Same effect. Finally you will get the same answers also. Understanding or not? Once again solve the problems, then you can understand easily. In the next class, I will go through the bank reconciliation statement. Okay. Thank you all.